Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Kazooie. Right now, we are still in Gobi's Valley and surrounded by all of this sand. Pillars of salt and pillars of sand. If you know the song, you're awesome. But anyway, we'll be collecting more stuff in this area, and hopefully, I don't think we'll finish it off, but hopefully getting that much closer to finishing off the world as a whole, maybe in this part and the next part, but I can't really determine that. So anyway, let's just resume on collecting some notes here and hopefully picking up another Jiggy or two, or three, or four, or five, or six. Oh, LeBron James, you're so easy to make fun of. Oh, man. So anyway, let's just get these notes surrounding the little lake right here. And it's nice to finally see water in this place. Oh, man. I was kind of thirsty for a second there. Oh yeah, so let's actually get this done with first. We see more of these things that you shoot eggs into. And when you get on the pillar, they actually move. So getting them in their mouth is very hard. That doesn't sound suggestive at all. Oh man, so there we go, that's one. Alright, so ooh, it reveals a pyramid kind of thing. Okay, and there's a Mumbo token right there. So pretty much if you don't get the picture already, we'll be going around this water thing, putting eggs in their mouths. And the pillar will, or the pyramid will rise up from the ashes or the sand. Oh, come on, open your mouth! Eat all your vegetables and your eggs. Eggs. Come on, be more like Ed. Chickens! Oh, man, he had a problem. Oh, man. They should have, like, a rehab session of, like, Ed with eggs and, like, chickens and butter toast and all that jazz and gravy. Oh man, I wonder what he would grow up as. I don't know. It'd probably be like the president, like they did in Anchorman with Brick. Or he was like the advisor to the president. I don't know. It's pretty funny nonetheless. Oh wow, we're actually closer with this one, but it moves faster, so it's kind of harder. Or tougher, and it's not a sentence before. Is that fully builded? Yeah, I think it does. Alright, so that wasn't hard at all. So now that we reveal the pyramid, let's actually go inside of it. And see what bountiful treasures reside inside. Now, we definitely don't want to forget about that Mumbo token up there.
Welcome, welcome.
And let's see what's inside. Oh, what the hell? This is King Sandybutch's tomb. Turn back or face his wrath. Hey, I ain't scared. Banjo-Kazooie doesn't afraid of anything. You choose not to heed our warning. Prepare to run! Oh my god, this is one of the scariest things in the game to me. You have to complete this maze within the 50-second time limit, or you basically die. And you definitely want to pick up the Witch Switch right here as fast as possible. And oh wow, a Jiggy is actually in the sarcophagus. I always thought it was like a 1,000-year-old dead person, but yeah, you want to fill this thing in the time. I mean, the music doesn't help as well. You have to complete this maze as quickly as possible within the time limit, or you die, like I said. Oh my god. Crap. Oh, I know how to beat it. Oh, it's Wolio back here, though. Crap. I'm getting so stressed out right now. And that doesn't help. Alright. Oh, no. I'm dead. Oh, my God. I can't believe I didn't freaking solve this. Oh, God. Look at this graphic image. Are you kidding? Like that? Oh my god! That's so gruesome! Holy crap! Spikes just landed on our head, man! Oh my god! Luckily there's no blood in this game, like some other games Rare made. Oh man, but anyway, let's try that again. I don't know why I didn't have that in front of me. Why? I don't know. It's pretty hard to tell which area leads to what, so that's why I get rather confused in this area, obviously. And where's the entrance? Okay. Very bad camera angle right there. Oh, there we go. The thing's right there. I thought that was a different room. That's why I didn't even expect the Sandy Butts lair, so... Alright, I guess we're gonna try that again with the thing in front of me this time. Alright, seems we gotta hug the left side. I thought it was the right side for some reason. I don't know. Alright, we already went over the formalities. You're gonna kill me. I have unlimited lives, basically. You can't kill me. Alright, so we gotta go to the left side, it said, so, oh, gold feathers, okay, we're kind of out of time limit, but, some sightseeing, I guess, alright, so let's try it this way. Yeah, when the less time you have, the faster the music goes. I always hated when games did that. Alright, dead end there, but I think we got it this time. We just have to hug this side around. roll around here, and there we go. Oh, wait, whoa, dead end. Holy crap, okay, go this way. Yay, we got it this time, oh my god. Ah, well, time to spare. No, the bear survived! He's after the king's ancient relic. I wonder what the king's ancient relic is. Oh my god, it's a Jiggy, I'm so surprised. I'm not being sarcastic at all. Alright, so that's Jiggy number 4, and you definitely want to search inside of all of these pots, because inside of one of the pots, you get a Mumbo token, but in this one, you get a purple Jinjo! Aw, a little present. That orange one kind of looks brown there, if you just saw that, that was kind of weird. Oh man, so that's- Whoa. Okay, we don't want to fall off the cliff, man. Alright, so what are we gonna do next? Let's see here. Scrolling my pages right here. Oh, okay, we'll do that. I was kind of just shooting darts at it. I don't even know. I'm not even following my strategy guide. I can't play and, like, look at a strategy guide at the same time. And within a time limit, nonetheless, no way. I'm freestyling it. Please. It's way too impossible to do that at once. We'll do both at the same time, for that matter. I don't know. Yeah, let's meet an old friend. Let's do that. We're not an old friend. We never see him in the LP, but we see him a ton of times throughout the Banjo-Kazooie franchise series. Right word, I don't even know. But, let's do this first, then we'll meet him. He's in the distance back there if you can't see him. He's the camel dude. Like, what's with the cutscenes taking over the time? I don't get that. And really, you need a time limit for that? Come on. If you can't make a time in that, or you can't get inside there before the time limit's done, you have problems. Okay, he just survived a golden wing attack? I beg to differ on that one. Okay, so over here we have a bit of a puzzle game, so it's kind of always like puzzle games as a kid, but especially it always reminds me of Mario Party with that puzzle match game. It was like one of the first games you could do in that minigame series, I think. But I don't know, so you get 100 seconds to do this. It's not like you have like 30 seconds, so take your time on here, just use your old memory. Alright, Mumbo is in the top left, and I don't know if it's random, I think it's already a predetermined set where all the things are. So I don't think you can memorize it, or it doesn't change or whatever. I think you can memorize it if you felt like it, but I don't know why, but... Well, I guess we're gonna determine what my memory skills are in this little area. This should be the honeycomb, I believe. That's Kazooie. Kazooie was over here. What's over here? Yeah, I'm sorry about the enthralling commentary right here, but I'm just trying to use my brain on this one and not, like, zone out and mess up. Oh, okay. Yeah, I think it was this one. No, it's the blue egg. Blue egg is down here. Yeah, I don't know. I used to be pretty good at concentration-type games, but I don't know. They're pretty hard. I think it's all about memory, and my memory is not exactly the best. My memory's shot in real life, or... What am I saying in real life? I always say that. I don't know. Aw, oh, man, because in video games, my memory obviously is fake, I guess. Aw, oh, man. Alright, so two more to go, and there we go. We finally beat up that puzzle, and for our reward, we get none other than... Okay, that... Whoa, that... Okay, that was kind of weird. We were supposed to do, like, a little, camera angle out there, but it somehow zoomed in because I was right inside of the Jiggy. And that was pretty weird. Let's see over here. Back here, I believe there's something of importance. Oh, yeah, we got this thing. Definitely want to collect some feathers. We'll be doing some flying later, if you haven't already guessed it, because we haven't done it yet in this area. And we get an empty honeycomb right inside of that cactus with eyes. That's kind of weird. Why does everything have a face in this? And I know I really want to wait for the magic carpet. You know what? I don't care. I'm friends with the pocket sand. He'll understand. Alright, let's... Oh, come on! Really? That carpet wasn't nice there. Oh, look at this poor guy over here. What the hell's up, buddy? It's too hot for Gobi! I need some shade, please! Help me! Help me! Somebody, please! I've been tied up and I can't get up! Alright, so that chick's thing wasn't the actual person of the area. Gobi was this guy's name, so that means it's his valley. That's pretty cool. Yay, we freed him! Here's your reward, bear! Gobi's off to cool down! Alright, so cool down, buddy. You deserve a nice long rest. So that's Jiggy numero 6. So, okay. Oh, we almost landed on that, but I don't care. There's an empty honeycomb thing, or what am I talking about? There's a honeycomb filler-upper right there. Yes, the filler-upper bounty. Oh, man, those commercials. Oh, God, get out of there! Get out of there! Oh man, those bees just took a freaking walloping on my ass right there. My bear ass. Let's see here. I think we went inside of all the areas except this one, but this one can only be obtained to go inside, or it can only get inside of it by flying. And we have to do that one still. We gotta do a lot of flying jiggies in this one, I can see. So I pretty much have a general idea of all the jiggies remaining, unlike the last area when I was kind of like guessing and stuff, so at least I'm better in terms of that. So let's just get on this fly pad right here. I think it's the only fly pad in the area, so you have to go all the way back to this guy whenever you get a chance. And over here we have a nice big target with Kazooie on it. Okay, that's kind of weird. They made a shrine of Kazooie. What, is there multiple Kazooies in this Kazooie universe? Or the Banjo-Kazooie universe? Oh man, now they put the timer in the cutscene. Oh my god. That's getting really annoying real fast, so... Oh well, what are you gonna do? But inside of here we have... What the hell? Got this, like, Indian dude. I think it's an Indian. I'm not gonna try to be racist here. Hello, my friend. I am Ruby. Can I be of some help, you know? We're looking for a treasure pipe, boy. Very good. I see some up there. It's yours if you can get it, yes? Oh man, I'm sorry about the stereotypical, like, accent right there, but come on. You had to, like, put two and two together. I was just assuming. Come on. I am no racist. I don't know. They just throw out... they just throw out mumbo tokens just anywhere, and this is probably one of the hardest notes to get because you have no idea what's back here. How would you know? You have to freaking know the notes are back there. Why else would you think it's there? There's a concave in the wall, yes, but how else would you know? Oh, and this part's my favorite. We gotta fart into this. We gotta sacrifice this Indian man by farting. Oh man, that's great. That's not demeaning at all. Ah, 1,000 thanks, my friend. His stuff will now help you with the power of friendship. I mean, your quest. What the hell? Whoa, whoa, whoa! My god, this guy has a long neck. I'm not talking about Littlefoot from the Land Before Time, but anyway, that's Jiggy number 7. Oh man, thanks a lot, and he actually whistles the theme to this world. Oh man, I always like the themes to this world, and sped up is actually very nice, but stressful. It brings back a lot of painful memories. Alright, so let's see here. We got some notes over there. I definitely want to explore over there, but... First, what the hell? Wait, why was that down? That's kind of weird. Okay, I'm not gonna... discuss about that. Oh god, the sand. The sand and the sand and the sand and the sand. Oh, whoa, whoa, Jesus, what are you following me for? God, I'm just an innocent bystander in the gist of things. Alright, so let's see here. Another flying thing we'll just get out of the way now is the, we gotta fly through some rings, I guess. Actually, you know what, that's gonna take too long, so you might as well just get the wading boots on and get all the things surrounding the sand. Such as notes and stuff, and there's a one-up right here. I don't know if we're gonna make this all one turn, so we're not gonna... I don't think we'll be able to do that, so let's just go back here, hit B, and get the wading boots again. There we go. It's kind of like refreshing your red cap or your metal hat from Super Mario 64, so you just gotta know the timer, because the timer always differs between worlds, so it's kind of hard to get a measure of time between what the running boots length is and what the waiting boots length is, so it's kind of a coin flip and just a guesstimate for that matter. But anyway, yes, I think we'll have to end it off here because we're running out of time. Oh, there's Gobi back there. I guess he's getting a drink. With the nuts guy? Come on, Gobi, you're better than that kid. But anyway, yes, I think we'll have to end it here. Thank you guys for watching. Next time, we will be finishing off Gobi's Valley, hopefully, and be that much closer to the next world, I guess, and I'm just running on sentencing right here. And that's not a sentence at all. God damn, I cannot talk. See you later, guys, and until next time.